So I first met Sakis about 10 years ago, and we were working later on my first book, which was Black Metal Evolution of the Cult.
I trusted somehow your way of writing and your purposes. So I say we are 30-year band. If not now the time, then when?
I think we worked on this book for 3 years in total.
In total,
from
yes.
The first interview.
We had many bands out there. They gave the best in order to create this Hellenic black metal, and I think all this scene created something remarkable.
And I think the book, to be fair, it's a biography of Rotting Christ, but there is also, it is also about the genesis of extreme metal and underground metal and black metal within Greece.
Greece, it was the first country actually from Southern Europe that follow this Norwegian black
metal. Well, predates it, really, because you're making black metal in 89, which is pre
yes, together with Mayhem, yes, you know, all these glorious names, Norway, and I think Norway was stronger than now, of course, but yeah. I think that we also put our own mark. The atmosphere we created back in the days was different from the Norwegian and Scandinavian bands. We didn't talk about forest and stuff like that, because we come from a country not that cold, not that frozen, so maybe our mentality was different, and that's why we, even if we play black metal, we played more atmospheric, something that the Scandinavian bands missed, I think, in my opinion.
And people talk about this warm Greek sound, and I think
it was quite warm. Yeah,
there's quite a lot of keyboards, quite a lot of heavy metal influence.
Well, more heavy metal influence, yes.
Not so fast songs compared to the some fast, but I mean some
fast. Actually, nothing was too fast back in the days.
Yeah.
It was more, as you said, more metal influenced and more keyboards maybe sometimes.
Yeah.
In the beginning, I remember that we were really judged from the people. Why you use keyboards? You are a faggot or something like that. Yes, but keyboards created an atmosphere,
right.
Something that many bands followed later
and,
on.
And Bathory had already kind of introduced
that. Of course, Bathory was our main influence.
Yeah, I mean, I think if you listen to Greek black metal from the mid-90s, early 90s, a big part of it is that kind of occult, archaic, obscure atmosphere.
Exactly.
Whereas Norway and Sweden were maybe a little bit more about being cold and evil and that sort of darkness.
Yes.
Greek scene had a sort of different atmosphere.
Yes.
More like you felt like you were hearing something from the ancient past, you know?
Yes, maybe. That all Greek people have somewhere deep in their DNA some roots from the past. These influences comes out without understand this. They just came out. So even if we talk about Satan, we still have some these pagan influences from our past.
I think one part of the book, which maybe a lot of black metal fans and a lot of Rotting Christ fans won't be aware of, is the fact that you guys, Jim, Themis, and yourself, were basically fighting with police a lot in your youth.
Of course. That was the spirit.
Yeah.
It still is, actually, somehow.
This kind of anarchism. And
yes. I can't say ideologically nowadays we are anarchists or something, but still, you know, our past led us and influenced us nowadays.
There's a square, isn't there, in Athens, which is traditionally...
Yes, we grew up there. Yeah.
So tell us a little bit about that square.
It's a central square, Exarchia Square, where all the black metal bands, not only anarchists, also, you know, had their own place, you know, where you can change ideas. So we create somehow the spirit. We're influenced from the spirit. They were still influenced from the spirit. Otherwise, we wouldn't do something like this. Is for me something very important, unite people, you know. For me, metal should unite people and not divorce.
Yeah, and I think it's interesting because this square, which has so much history with the sort of anti-police actions, and
yes,
this is where Storm Studio was, so
yes,
these classics.
Exactly. Every night, you know, we had this kind of action, you know, listen, you know, right, let's be something like a rebels or something, you know. When you feel rebel, you create better music,
yeah,
in my opinion.